Splanchnic Circulation. Chapter 110. Introduction. Splanchnic or visceral circulation constitutes three portions: mesenteric circulation supplying blood to GI tract, splenic circulation supplying blood to spleen, hepatic circulation supplying blood to liver. Unique feature of splanchnic circulation is that the blood from mesenteric bed and spleen forms a major amount of blood flowing to liver. Blood flows to liver from GI tract and spleen through portal system. Mesenteric circulation. Distribution of blood flow. Stomach, 35 ml/100 g/min. Intestine, 50 ml/100 g/min. Pancreas, 80 ml/100 g/min. Regulation of mesenteric blood flow. Mesenteric blood flow is regulated by the following factors: local autoregulation. Local autoregulation is the primary factor regulating blood flow through mesenteric bed, Chapter 102. Activity of gastrointestinal tract. Contraction of the wall of the GI tract reduces blood flow due to compression of blood vessels. And relaxation of wall of GI tract increases the blood flow due to removal of compression on the vessel wall. Nervous factor. Mesenteric blood flow is regulated by sympathetic nerve fibers. Increase in sympathetic activity, as in the case of emotional conditions or fight and flight reactions, constrict the mesenteric blood vessels. So, more blood is diverted to organs like skeletal muscles, heart, and brain, which need more blood during these conditions. Parasympathetic nerves do not have any direct action on the mesenteric blood vessels. But these nerves increase the contraction of GI tract, which compresses the chemical factors, functional hyperemia. Functional hyperemia is the increase in mesenteric blood flow immediately after food intake. It is mainly because of gastrin and cholecystokinin secreted after food intake. In addition to these two GI hormones, digestive products of food substances such as glucose and fatty acids also cause vasodilatation and increase the mesenteric blood flow. Splenic circulation. Importance of splenic circulation. Spleen is the main reservoir for blood. Due to the dilatation of blood vessels, a large amount of blood is stored in spleen. And the constriction of blood vessels by sympathetic stimulation releases blood into circulation. Storage of blood. In spleen, two structures are involved in storage of blood, namely splenic venous sinuses and splenic pulp, Chapter 25. Small arteries and arterioles open directly into the venous sinuses. When spleen distends, sinuses swell and large quantity of blood is stored. Capillaries of splenic pulp are highly permeable. So, most of the blood cells pass through capillary membrane and are stored in the pulp. Venous sinuses and the pulp are lined with reticuloendothelial cells. Regulation of blood flow to spleen. Blood flow to spleen is regulated by sympathetic nerve fibers. Hepatic circulation. Blood vessels. Liver receives blood from two sources: hepatic artery, portal vein. More details are given in Chapter 40. Normal blood flow. Liver receives maximum amount of blood as compared to any other organ in the body, since most of the metabolic activities are carried out in the liver. Blood flow to liver is 1500 ml/min, which forms 30% of the cardiac output. It is about 100 ml/100 g of tissue/min. Normally, about 1100 ml of blood flows through portal vein and remaining 400 ml of blood flows through hepatic artery. However, portal vein carries only about 25% of oxygen to liver. It is because it carries the blood, which has already passed through the blood vessels of GI tract, where oxygen might have been used. Hepatic artery transports 75% of oxygen to the liver. Regulation of blood flow to liver. Blood flow to liver is regulated by the following factors: systemic blood pressure. Systemic blood pressure is the important factor responsible for blood flow to liver, and hepatic blood flow is directly proportional to systemic blood pressure. Splenic contraction. During splenic contraction, blood flow to liver increases. Movements of intestine. Motility of intestine increases hepatic blood flow. Chemical factors. Chemical factors which increase the blood flow to liver by vasodilatation are: excess carbon dioxide, lack of oxygen, increase in hydrogen ion concentration. Nervous factors. Sympathetic fibers to liver cause vasoconstriction in liver and decrease the blood flow. Sympathetic fibers to liver and other portions of splanchnic circulation pass through splanchnic nerve. Role of parasympathetic fibers in hepatic circulation is not known.